recently spoke with her about the inspiration behind her new music and how she's adjusting to life as a busy working mom. Ellie, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
We're thrilled to have you. Well, you know, you have this new album and it's called Higher Than Heaven. And I read that you wrote it during the pandemic and it's almost like an antidote to the despair of that time.
Definitely. When I got back in the studio with the guys that I wrote it with, nobody was in the mood to write ballads. And Brightest Blue was, my previous album was much more personal and deep. And I really had to, go into myself to write that. And it was just refreshing to go in and be like, let's just write some big pop records. And so we did.
I've listened to some of the tracks. It's all about love and uplift. And I read that you were also expecting your first child, your son, at the time. How did that impact, do you think, your songwriting and your artistry?
I think at that time, it was still all very surreal to me. I was perhaps, slightly in denial about it all happening, but in a good way, in that, I wasn't letting it kind of take over. I didn't come in and, say like, guys, I just really want to write about being pregnant,
Yeah.
I just went in and wanted to do what I love doing, which is just writing music.
I read that you had said, motherhood wasn't always one of your goals and that this wasn't something that, you were reaching for necessarily.
No, it was definitely a surprise. And, being pregnant for the first time is a bit daunting. You don't really know what to expect. I think I had a good sense of humor about it. I was just like, it's happening. It's happening. I'm just gonna let it happen.
And how's working motherhood so far?
I mean, it's wild. It's really wild, but it's incredible. It's one of those things where you learn every day. You pick up different things. He's changing by the hour, and so you have to keep up with it. And it makes you, it's made me more of a positive person. It's made me more kind of patient. All the things that I lost along the way, with my job and other things. And suddenly to go back to just sitting on the floor for half an hour watching him play, it just grounds you so
and
much.
And how does that compare to the frenetic pace that you had throughout your 20s? Because, your love life was in the tabloids. It was messy. It was rough.
That was fun. That was just so fun. that stuff isn't real.
It's a facade of some sort.
Yeah, in a way. I know that, it comes with the territory a bit, just because naturally when you put music out into the world, people are fascinated by where has that song come from and just start to become interested in you. We're now addicted to finding out things about people and wanting to know all the time. The more it intensifies, the more you can actually come back out of it and be like, that stuff is just like not the real world.
You're not only putting out a new album, you have a new streaming special, and you shot it at a very special place, especially given your environmentalist background.
Kew Gardens in Richmond in the UK. It's so beautiful. If you ever get to go to the UK, please do visit.
Actually, we have a clip, so let's take a look.
Is it love? Call it chemical, the way you touch. So unforgettable, feel the rush. I don't wanna sleep with fever dreams when I'm with you. Feel like the summer.
It's like you're in a magical botanical garden.
Yeah,
literally.
That's literally what it is. And it houses all these beautiful and rare plants. And it also has like a seed bank which houses seeds from all over the world, ready for doomsday,
Amazing.
Cheery. But it's pretty remarkable, like the processes it all has to go through.
So you're an environmentalist. Your monarch, King Charles, is a big environmentalist. And you famously sang at Kate and Will's wedding reception.
I did. Many
years ago. And yet, will you be performing at the coronation?
Oh my goodness, I have no idea. I think I'll be on tour. I haven't quite planned it yet, but I'm sure it's gonna be an incredible day.
Sure.
I think people are really excited to celebrate it. It's been quite a tough few years in the UK and everywhere, really.
Sure.
I don't think anyone's escaped, the events that are happening in the world. But obviously our beloved Queen passed away. And so I think it's just something to look forward to. And they'll have an amazing lineup, whoever it is.
And so now, what's next for you? What are the projects you're looking for in your horizon?
Lots of things, actually. I have a few different things I'm working on, but I'm working on this classical project, which I'm very excited about. Mm. And then we're also trying to figure out how we can do the tour as green as physically possible, and you know, really try and make a mark so that other people can follow suit, other artists and people on the road. So I just feel like we have a responsibility to do that.
Thank you for using your platform to help the environment, and thanks for showing up today.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Really lovely to meet you.
You too.